Welcome children to the next part of the video and the chapter sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In the previous two videos we have discussed about the structure of the androecium and we have also done the structure of microsporangium. Now in this video we are going to start with microsporogenesis. So before I start with microsporogenesis, I will again give you a brief up on the structure of microsporangium. As you see here, these are the microsporangiums in the four corners. Okay, so one of them has been, you know, elaborated and shown it to you here. Okay, so you see, this is the microsporangium. Okay, so the outermost layer is the epidermis. This one is the epidermis. Then the next to the epidermis is endothelium. And after the endothelium, few layers of middle layers, and the innermost layer is the tapetum. Okay, now inside there are pollen grains present, and at the center, as I told you in the previous video also, at the center there will be sporogenous tissue. Now because there are tissue, they are tissue, that means lot of cells will be there. Tissue is combination of lot of cells. So sporogenous tissue, which is compactly arranged, and this tissue is made up of sporogenous cells, and the cells are diploid. Remember, the cells of sporogenous tissue are diploid. Okay, now you see children, the main topic that we are going to discuss here is microsporogenesis. Now children, microspore are the male gametes, and genesis means the production or the formation of male gamete. So as you see again, this is a the anther. Okay, and these are the four microsporangia. You can see the four microsporangia. As the anther develops, each sporogenous cell, as I told you, the sporogenous cells or tissue are present at the center. Here at the center, they are present at the center. Okay, so each sporogenous cell or microspore, or you also call them as pollen mother cell, and we all know that they all are diploid. I just told you that sporogenous cells are diploid. So either you call sporogenous cell, or you call them microspores, or you call them pollen mother cell, they are diploid. They will undergo meiotic division. Because they are diploid, they will undergo meiotic division or reductional division to give rise to microspore tetrads. Now we all know that meiosis, when meiosis occur, when for meiosis one will happen occur, two dyad will be formed, and after meiosis two, tetrad will be formed. So the ultimate result of meiosis is a tetrad, right? So the pollen mother cell, when it undergoes meiotic division to form microspores, we will get tetrad, that is four microspores which are arranged in a cluster of four cells. You see here, they have shown you. Now this is a microsporangia, a microsporangium. The tapetum is there, epidermis is there, and the pollen grains are also there. Now the pollen mother cell, from the sporogenous tissue, the pollen mother cell, which is diploid, it undergoes meiosis. Now when it undergoes meiosis, the whole process of meiosis is finished, we get a tetrad. You see, tetrad of pollen. Now when this tetrad of pollen will separate, I will get four pollen grains, right? So the formation of microspores from a pollen mother cell, now microspores are formed, and they are formed from pollen mother cell. This process of formation of microspores from pollen mother cell by the process of meiosis is called microsporogenesis. Okay, so this is what is microsporogenesis. Now what happens as the anther matures? Now the anther will get mature, it will dehydrate, that means it will dry up, dehydrate means the moisture content will be, you can say, transpiration will occur and all the moisture will be taken out. It will dehydrate, it will dry up, and when it will dry up, it will dehiscize. Dehiscize means it will burst out, and the microspores dissociate from each other and develop into pollen grains. You see, the microspores which were all together, the tetrad was all together. Now, because the pollen has got matured up, because it has dehydrated, they will separate out. See, it gets separated, and when they will get separated out, each microsporangium contains thousands of pollen grains. Lot of pollen grains are present in each microsporangium, okay? And they are released when the anther will dehiscize or when the anther will burst. Now, why is the anther bursting? There are two reasons for the anther to burst. One is that it is full of pollen grains. It is packed with pollen grains from inside. And the second reason is it has dehydrated, it has dried up, and because of that, it is dehiscizing, it is bursting up, and all the pollen grains are released out. Is it clear? Okay, so this is all about microsporogenesis.